Hey everyone, I've been asked a few times if I can demonstrate a method on replacing the reflection that's seen within sunglasses. Sometimes a reflection can actually make or break the overall effect of the image. Now if you'd rather read this tutorial instead of watching it, the written version along with many others are waiting for you over at the brand new ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com. Let's begin. In the photo in front of us, the reflection in the sunglasses is quite boring. We're going to attempt to replace it with a semi-exciting beach scene. The first thing that needs to be done is the selection. This will allow us to isolate the sunglasses from the rest of the image. In Photoshop, there are many ways to create a selection. The lasso tools, the pen tool, the magic wand tool, and the quick selection tool, to name a few. Because the sunglasses will typically be standing out from everything else around it, we can safely use the quick selection tool in this case. The quick selection tool is simple to use. As you click or drag your mouse around an area, Photoshop will do its best to include similar areas in your selection. As your selection is being created, don't worry if extra bits are added. You can simply hold down your Alt or Option key to subtract from the selection. Once your selection is more or less complete, if you're running Photoshop CS5, I'd suggest refining your edge, especially if there are any stray hairs around your glasses, which you want to deal with. CS5 includes the Smart Radius feature, which does a much better job at those smaller areas. I'd also strongly recommend outputting the selection as a new layer with layer mask here at the bottom. This will ensure that if we want to make changes to the selection later on, we can easily edit the layer mask. When you accept your changes, your original layer may become hidden. If it does, simply trigger its visibility from the layers panel on the right-hand side. So now that we have our sunglasses on its own layer with an active layer mask, there's one step I want to take in order to better prepare the effect. Currently, we can clearly see the reflection of the original background. I want to darken it up just enough so that it won't affect the new image that we're going to be replacing it with. A brightness and contrast adjustment layer should do the trick. Adjustment layers can be added at the bottom of your layers panel. When you add this adjustment, you want to make sure to clip the adjustment to the layer directly below it so it doesn't affect the whole image. For the values, negative 120 and 60 seem to work well for this image, but depending on the image that you're working with, you'll probably have to tweak the settings a touch. Don't worry if a slight reflection is still visible, I'd prefer that over a completely black object. Now we're ready to add the new image. I've gone ahead and opened this picture of a beach and resized it to around 500 pixels wide. We don't need a massive image if we're only fitting it within the sunglasses. From here, I can simply drag this image onto my original document and move it in place on top of the sunglasses. Once the new image is in place, in your Layers panel, find that new layer, right-click on it, and choose Create Clipping Mask. This will place the beach image inside our sunglasses where we can still move it around if we desire. But now we see two issues. The first issue is that there still may be areas around the border which don't look that great. This is one of the reasons why I suggested adding to a new layer with Layer Mask. In this case, we can select the layer mask below and with a black brush, paint the areas which we want hidden, or use a white brush to reveal the areas that are hidden. This will help clear up the edges quite a bit. The second issue is that it's clearly not very reflective. Here's how we're going to deal with that. In your layers panel, select the layer with the beach image and then change the blend mode to hard light, and then decrease the opacity to around 30%. Again, keep in mind that depending on the images that you're working with, you'll need to tinker with the settings. I found that hard light, and linear dodge work pretty well, but play around with the different blending modes and opacities to see which result you like. You may even like the result that color dodge outputs. From here, you can add additional adjustment layers to heighten the effect. I'm going to add a levels adjustment layer in order to brighten up the highlights just a touch. And there you go, sunglass reflections in Photoshop. If you want to submit your own Photoshop questions, or if you want to check out additional tutorials, check out the brand new ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com and like us on Facebook over at facebook.com/ICEFLOWSTUDIOS. Take care.